Could someone please let my family know I'm still in this voiceover booth? Tonight, on About Tonight, it's your host, Rose Callaghan.
Hello, and welcome to About Tonight. It's your host, me. Rose Callaghan, that's my name. It's such a pleasure to be here. I'm really excited for the show tonight. We've got a lot of amazing guests coming up, so strap yourselves in. But before that, I would like to introduce to you my fabulous house band, Spod. Thanks for coming in.
That's all right, no props.
You've just flown here?
Cats. Yeah, I just flew here from Sydney.
Yeah, cool.
It's pretty sweet.
And boy, are your arms tired.
I've heard that.
That's great. Who did you fly with?
Jetstar.
Yeah.
I don't endorse them, but what can you do?
You did refuse to fly with Tiger.
Yeah, my days of Tiger are definitely over.
You've been in the music industry for quite some time now.
Yeah, I've missed way too many shows and professional engagements because of Tiger.
Well, that's really good that you have that professional attitude, because this is a very professional show that we have here tonight. Have you ever been on a Tonight show before?
No, I haven't.
Okay. Well, I feel like... And I don't want to put too much pressure on you, but I feel like this could be a really good opportunity for us.
All right, great.
I think that like Rove hasn't been doing stuff for a while.
Yeah.
I mean, I am a woman though, so that's a pretty big disability.
That is kind of gross.
Yeah, it is pretty gross.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
It's all right.
I've got my period. Anyway, so I prepared, I got my fringe cut. And
nice.
As you can see, it cost $5. And that is what a $5 fringe looks like.
It's pretty straight.
Straight enough. I don't know. Does anyone have like a spirit level or something? It's not. It sort of like goes down like that. But this is my hair and makeup artist, you know, couldn't come today because they're in LA.
Yeah, yeah.
You
no,
know,
I feel
scouting
it.
For me because they're also my agent as well.
Yeah, so right.
Yeah, yeah.
It's
that's
good
where your agent is as well at the moment.
Pretty
right?
much.
Yeah.
I cut as many costs as I can, so I fired everyone. I just have a social media manager now, and that's all you really need. It's 2016. It's time to get on with life. And, social media, it's where it's at. So I have a guy, Bruce Tan, that looks after all my
Bruce
stuff.
Bruce Tan.
Yeah.
Are you on Periscope?
Probably. I don't know. I don't get online.
We might be on Periscope. Right now, who knows?
I could Periscope.
Do you get much track? What's your favorite platform? You know, like Instagram, Facebook, Twitter?
I'll tell you what, it's got to be Twitter because it's free form and it's a lot of fun. You can do whatever you want on Twitter.
Yeah, that's true.
You can say, like, my mum doesn't check out Twitter, but
that's
she checks
true.
Out Facebook.
And says, like, she'll comment.
Yeah, she's like,
stuff.
Oh, that's great. I'm like,
I don't want to hear it, mum.
Yeah.
I'm
these
busy.
I've got real friends on here.
Yeah.
Twitter, it's like, no one cares.
I know you from
want.
Twitter.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
There you go.
There you go.
That's pretty cool.
And here we are now. So, yeah, that's pretty exciting. You know, do you have a favourite Tonight show that you like to watch?
Definitely David Letterman was my favourite.
Yeah.
He was a professional dude.
Yeah.
And he used to be a lot of fun. And that's kind of it. Conan O'Brien, I've seen his once before. That was pretty good too.
In person?
Yeah.
I saw him in person
actually,
too.
I saw David Letterman in person, not Conan. I lied.
Oh,
I said
okay.
Yes just to... No.
You said, oh, that's okay. That's good. I saw Conan one time, but it was like he had really shit guests on.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. Like this tonight, like this is the shit right here. But he had like not the star of like a really bad movie and a band of old people that I'd never heard of.
Gross.
Like, yeah, gross.
What are they, who was on Letterman? There was it was someone pretty good. They're all like the kind of guys from cool TV shows like The Sopranos, but
cool.
Not the lead guy.
Oh, yeah.
One
see,
of the other dudes.
They couldn't get that guy.
No. And then I think maybe like an old wrestler. Oh, no, Charles Barkley.
Oh.
Yeah, that was pretty rad. He's a
basketball
player from America, so... That was pretty cool.
That's really cool. When I went to Conan O'Brien, he said, because a lot of people don't know this, but Conan O'Brien looks like the former president of a Scandinavian country, the name of which I've forgotten.
Yeah, right.
What a cool fact, guys. A lot of cool Google facts it. Coming up on the show. But whenever he, like to the audience, he always goes, hey, who's here from country? Finland. That's the one, Finland. Sounds and great. All the guys that I went there with were from Finland. So there you go.
Mind-blowing facts.
It's pretty...
hot off the press.
If
that's
you guys
insane.
Like facts, then you're in for a bloody a ride. Treat. A real big ride. So... you know, is there anything else that you want to put out there before we start? Like, not like we've started, but...
Oh, okay. Well, yeah. You know, just thanks for the opportunity.
Yeah.
I love coming down to Melbourne. It's a great place. A lot of good coffee. It's
yeah.
Cool laneway culture.
Have you seen the laneways? Yeah.
Yeah. I drank a few coffees already.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun.
Same. And I didn't sleep last night. And
no. Yeah. Well, you know, you're young and it's rebellious.
Good. I'm not
you
that know? Young.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Well, you know. Well, maybe you're just
I'm
stupid.
33. Yeah. I know. A lot of people think I look younger, but it's fine. Yeah. That's great. So, yeah.
We've got some hot stuff coming out.
Yeah.
Some hot records.
You do?
Yeah.
Like what?
Got an album called Adult Fantasy that I might finish this year.
Is that like a sex album?
It's kind of a sex album, but for like an old man sex album.
Okay.
A bit. There's like songs about swinging. And
oh, okay, cool.
There's a song just about having a cool time with your friends.
Yep. Which know, is also about swinging.
Which is pretty much about swinging.
Yeah.
And just having a good time with friends.
That's great.
Yeah. Well, but you don't get to see much anymore, so it's a
how old are you?
A bit too old to say.
Okay.
53.
Yeah. Wow. I wouldn't have picked you for more than
well,
like 50.
Thanks.
Yeah.
That means a lot.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. So well, I think that's a pretty great start to the show so far. So yeah. High five. We've got heaps of awesome guests coming up, so please stay tuned. You're on About Tonight with Rose Callaghan and Spod.
Thanks.
Hello and welcome back to About Tonight. I'm your host for this evening, Rose Callaghan, and here I have my musical guest, Spod.
Hi.
I'm really, really excited right now. I've been listening to a lot of tracks from this new artist and she's really making some waves on the blogosphere, Twitter, Facebook, everyone's talking about it. I'm really happy to introduce my next guest, Yolanda.
Boys night, time for a party. Boys night.
Hi. You look gorgeous.
Oh my God.
Oh, I got a little lippy on you.
It's boys it is. Night.
Wow, Yolanda is such, it's so amazing to have you here. I've just been reading a lot about you on blogs and, you know, that kind of stuff. How long have you been in the music industry for?
About 11 months now.
Wow. Mm. Wow, that's you know, you're quite new.
Yeah, well, it's always been my dream. I've always been really passionate. I've been singing and dancing from childhood, like, 7 years old, you know, and now I'm getting the chance finally after my divorce to explore that.
Yeah, great. Yeah. So, you know, what's your inspiration in your music?
Oh, well, I mean, when I was younger, you know, a lot of my idols were Mariah Carey, Anastacia,
I mean, like I can see that, yeah. Yeah, you're really, I'm just getting that kind of aura, like a really powerful aura from you as a presence, like, and I've interviewed a lot of people before, you know, but
thank
I don't know,
you.
I can kind of pick it, I feel like, yeah.
You can pick my star power.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, thanks, I mean, my producer, DJ Heroin, always tells me that I'm the number one diva in Australia.
Wow. It's a bit of competition. Tina Arena, hope you're not listening right now.
I don't think so. Yeah. She's
in France or something.
Exactly.
No one really knows. That's great. So DJ Heroin, like,
yep.
How did you meet up with him?
Well, I Googled music producers and he came up and I saw that he also ran a record label.
Yeah.
Ice Cold Records.
Wow.
And he also offered some PR services and things like that so he could really get my career going.
Yeah. So amazing. So he's paying for all this stuff for you.
No, I'm paying. Yeah. So
all right.
But that's that's cool because, like, I married a rich guy and then I divorced him.
Yeah, right. Oh, it's just weird. I think usually, like, record companies, they pay for your stuff and then if you make money, then like, you get the money back, like, you pay them back later.
I don't.
Yeah, it's just, oh, that's just normally how much money?
I don't think so.
How much money did you give it?
The monthly fee is $7,469.
Oh, okay. No, that's, I mean, he's doing your PR
and
stuff.
And for that, I get placement on the blog that he writes.
That's so good. Yeah, blogs are really important now, and that's really good.
Yeah, the internet.
Yeah, wow. So have you been going on trips and that sort of thing?
Yeah, I think I'm going to go to Japan soon.
Wow. You know, they like quirky stuff and, you know, in Japan, I think they'll just really like your energy there for sure.
Yeah, we were meant to go last year, but DJ Heroin just had too much work on. Yeah. So we got it put off a little bit.
Yeah.
But, you know, when the Jetstar sale happens again, he said he'd book
That's great.
Osaka.
Yeah, awesome. Well, I mean, like, what are your other passions, you know?
Thank you for asking, Rose, because I'm really passionate about a cause that harms all of our children. Yeah. It's the anti-vaccine movement. Vaccines contain neurotoxins that cause autism and other disturbances, and children's immune systems get overloaded by all the vaccines that they have to have under the age of 2.
Okay, Yeah, no, look, I live next door to Princes Hill Primary and there was just like a big outbreak there recently of the measles and, you know.
Yeah, that was my stepchild.
Okay, look, it's quite dangerous, like, don't you think, like, you just...
I just think, why endanger my child's delicate immune system?
Yeah, okay, good. Like, that's good. It's good to have something that you're passionate about, you know. Mine's refugees, but, you know, each to their own.
Yeah, usually refugees aren't vaccinated, so that's a plus.
Oh, boy. Great. Well, that's so great. What else are you doing with your time?
I spend a lot of time with my stepson, Antonio.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, so he's feeling a bit bereaved after the divorce, so yeah. We spend a lot of time together.
Wait, so he's your ex-husband's child?
Yes.
But you still hang out with him?
We were really close. Yeah. It was just a natural bond from the start, you know.
How old's he?
He's 18.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just 18.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you still see, does he look like his dad or?
No, not really, no. Yeah. Which is good.
Yeah. Do you still see your ex-husband or?
We have lunch like once a week, so yeah.
What does he think of your career? Like, what were you doing
before?
He is
so proud.
Oh, that's amazing.
He's really encouraging.
That's great.
He's just happy that I'm getting into a new industry.
Okay, well, so what were you doing before you got into music?
I made bags. I had a bag company.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Wow. So like an internet bag company.
Etsy, yeah.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah. It was really successful, but then I accidentally bought too much material and I couldn't sell it, so yeah.
So that was like, you know, you could earn a full living off Etsy.
Yeah. So also from already, yeah, I didn't have to buy food or have rent.
Yeah.
Because I was married.
Yeah. And that's
why
you do it.
Are you married, Rose?
No. I don't think, it's not really, probably not in the cards for me.
You should get married because...
Oh, really?
You don't know. You get all these legal perks end of it. Like,
no, it's just you have to get a boyfriend before you can get married. But,
oh.
Yeah, no. But I'm on the scene, I'm dating and stuff, and, you know, I'm on Tinder.
I'm dating too.
Oh, really? Yeah. Already?
I'm mostly on the ones that pair older women with younger
guys. Cougar life.
Well, I wouldn't say I'm a cougar because, you know, I'm still really young.
Yeah. How old are you?
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
How old do you think I am?
28. Okay. All right, well, you've got a little bit of a song to play
yes.
for us. I'm really excited. It's from
Me
your
too.
Album, White Hot. And what's yep. it called?
It's called Prince Not a King.
Amazing. All right.
You're going to need to unlock
the iPhone. Oh, sorry. Did you notice that I've got the latest iPhone?
It's really nice, and it's also pink.
It's rose gold.
Oh, rose gold.
Rose gold.
Yeah. Rose. DJ Heroin wasn't available.
DJ Heroin just put that on YouTube for me, and
oh, okay.
he said I can just use it whenever I want.
Okay,
so.
Cool. All right. Take it away.
Sorry, I don't really know the words yet. Prince, I'm looking for someone. He could be a friend of my stepson. As long as you promise I'm your only one, you'll be my one. Not a king, just a prince. That's it.
Yeah.
Wow.
All
thank
right.
you.
Thank you so much, Yolanda.
Thank
Check
you,
out
Rose.
Her album, White Hot, on iTunes.
Yep.
And we will be back after the break on About Tonight.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
What's that? Ryan Gosling? No, I told you I'm busy. Oh, hey guys. Welcome back to About Tonight. I'm your host, Rose Callaghan, with my house band, Spod, over here.
Hey guys.
I'm excited. Our next guest is a very great and very talented and very wise comedian man. Please welcome Bart Freebairn.
Yeah.
G'day, mate.
All right. Yes.
Do this.
Oh.
Do you know Spod?
I do now.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, we just communicated all the information we needed through our palms.
Oh, that's
true.
Great. That's how
residuals wet.
Yeah, it is a bit wet. It's all sweaty palm. Is that because you're nervous about getting grilled?
I have naturally sweaty palms. I'm not very good at business because of that.
Okay. Is that why you do comedy?
No. No, I did comedy just because I wanted to.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought you would yes and me and that you'd be like, yeah, that's why I did comedy, because a crazy situation happened. That's
I'm
okay.
I'm not an improviser.
Oh, not
I'm
like me.
Just a man, yeah.
I did improv for
yeah, I don't
13
have
months.
Yes and tattooed on my wrists.
Have you seen an improviser that had?
Yes, I do. I do know.
Just to remind them.
Yeah.
Of the two like main rules of improv. If you can't remember that. I have to, if I want to know the difference between left and right, I have to go like that.
I think it's so when they cut their wrists, it's like, yes, and. Yeah.
And then someone's like, and now you're in a rocket ship.
Yeah.
But you're dead.
Now you're a ghost. Oh.
Oh, crazy.
Yeah.
I don't know why I bag improv. Like, I used to do improv for ages, but, you know, and I think it's pretty good. Did you ever do improv?
No, but in a way, aren't we all improving life?
Improvising life. Yeah, that's really true.
Yeah,
I think that you're a very wise person.
Oh, thank you, Rose. I'm not sure if I am.
I think so.
I'm scrambling like everyone else, you know.
You like to give good advice, I think.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
A lot of time I'm just yelling at people.
Yeah.
To get away from me.
There's like two spectrums of Bart.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, yeah, like I think that we all should just be nice to each other. And then it's like, yeah, I'm a big bogan, like from Queensland.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. But like, because you moved from Queensland to here.
Mm-hmm.
How many years ago?
50 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
You look good.
Yeah, yeah. I've maintained my youthful looks on the soles of the damned.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So 50 years ago when you came here,
uh-huh.
like were you a massive bogan and then you got to Melbourne and you were like, ooh.
I don't think I've ever been a massive bogan, although I imagine a lot of bogans would say that as well.
Yeah.
I was upper middle class.
If a bogan is a bogan in the forest and no one's there to tell them they're a bogan, are they a bogan?
No, because a bogan's only a bogan because of the other cultural spectrum. If there's no spectrum, then they're just a person.
Yeah, that's...
You know, you've got to have an upper, lower and middle for any of them to be... What's autumn if there's no other seasons?
Mm.
You know.
Autumn is a rubbish season. That's what it is.
Oh, I'm all about it. I think it's a great season.
Mm. No, I disagree. I think it's the best season.
Oh, you think yeah. it's the best? Why is it the best season?
Because summer sucks and winter sucks.
Mm.
Spring, second best.
It's transitional seasons are really fun, especially in Melbourne because you get some perfect days, like the last couple of days. It's been a little bit humid, like today, the day before, but before that's just not too hot. It's beautiful. It's sunny. It's you can wear a jumper in the evening.
Mm.
It's not, you can sleep.
I don't know.
Hats off to that. That's great.
You don't like summer because you're from Sydney.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, our weather's always great.
It is.
So
yeah.
You know, I can pick and choose whatever I like because it's perfection all the time. So
yeah.
Sydney.
Wow.
Number one.
You don't have good coffee in Sydney.
No, we have the best coffee.
Oh, see, I think...
And,
what so about...
Heaps more rich people, which are way more fun.
Like yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, you know, we hang out, Centrepoint Tower, do the deals.
Yeah, yeah.
Talk about Melbourne. We just laugh.
What do you do now that there's no monorail? I would feel like rich people would always
We're planning a new one.
They've got nowhere to go.
Yeah. They just sit in their mansions.
Yeah. They've got a lot of harbour waterfront as well in Sydney as well.
Have you ever been on a yacht before?
I don't know. I've been on boats. I don't know if I've...
I went on a ferry in Thailand once. I almost died. That's
been on
different.
A canoe.
Yeah.
A rowboat. Maybe I've been on a yacht. I have no distinct memory. I can neither confirm nor deny that I've been on a yacht.
I did kayaking in outdoor ed in year 11.
Yeah. See, that's just a more personal yacht.
A cheaper, more personal yacht that you don't have to like call ahead to be like, my kayak's gonna go into these waters. You don't have to do that.
Yachts are synonymous with like wealth, aren't they?
Yeah.
Now, when they're just a medium sized sailboat.
Yeah.
Really?
Well, like yachts are synonymous with like rappers taking Instagram photos. Mm. Yeah, I think.
Yeah, or being out on a yacht, there's not really a lot to do.
I feel like that's where I want to get my career. I just want to get on the Instagram page of somebody on a yacht.
Oh, okay.
Somebody that has more than 100,000 followers.
See, I feel
like... Do you think that's reasonable?
Sounds great.
Yeah.
You should get to a point where you have your own private jet. I think that's...
I'm being realistic, you know, like that's just silly.
Aim high and then just hit the middle.
Okay.
So you're trying to hit like the Crown Lager level of...
I am.
Yeah,
I guess so. And I should be going for the like Cristal
mm-hmm.
or like whatever Jay-Z's vodka brand
Well, if he's Australian, it'll be Crown Lager.
Yeah.
I think Jay-Z's number one drink is Beyonce's urine. It's very exclusive.
More like Beyonce's tears. Did you see that elevator video where Solange punched him in the face?
Cilantro.
Solange. We're both wrong. We're so wrong. You have three podcasts, which I think is surely the most amount of podcasts that anybody in Melbourne has.
It's a few. Two that I do by myself weekly.
I don't know how you...
And one I do with my friend Demi Lardner, which is ace. One's a guided meditation podcast.
I know, I've listened to it.
And that's a very loose term of guided meditation. It's me telling people to relax and also swearing at them a little bit.
Yeah.
And then I have a solo one where it's almost like a audio blog.
Yep.
And then... We're not doctors with Demi, where we give advice.
Advice.
Yeah.
What's the best advice you've ever given on the podcast, do you reckon?
Oh, I don't know. Seek help from a medical professional.
Yeah. That's what you say to everyone.
Yeah, at the end of the day, when someone says, can you help me? You're like, nah, probably not really. You're going to be all right.
Yeah.
I've been bitten by a spider. Just run under a tap.
Yeah.
You'll be fine.
Do you give relationship advice?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We give anything that is... Any call we get in, we'll answer. If it's sensible, there's some joke calls that we don't answer.
Okay, right. Yeah, because like when we're at gigs together, I make you give me a lot of relationship advice.
Mm.
But I'm still single, but
yeah.
What's going on there? You'll have to, I blame you.
It's a complicated problem, Rose. And it's not just up to you.
Boring.
It's not just up to you, is it? No. Really, when a relationship happens, it's got to, both people got to be on board.
That is very true.
It's
pretty
hard.
You know.
Look, hard work.
You've got a show in the comedy festival.
I do.
Called Unlimited Comedy Battle Spirit.
Yep.
Yeah, that's
Yeah, you know it.
Yeah,
yeah
I know
you know it.
Yeah.
1 hour only. Yeah.
Yeah, so you're doing every single night of the festival.
Every night!
Unlimited Comedy. It's at the Imperial Hotel.
That's right, 9:15.
9:15.
It's
every
the best.
Night.
The best.
Same time every night.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, thank you very much, Bart.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Go Autumn.
And go to
Autumn.
The show.
All right.
Hello and welcome back to About Tonight with your host, me, Rose Callaghan, and my musical guest, Spod. I'm very excited now. We have an Australian comedy legend in our midst. Please welcome now to the show, Libbi Gorr. Do I come through? Thank you so much for coming on the show. That was an abrupt ending.
Yeah, it was meant to be a smooth fade out. I apologise.
This is my professional musical house band, Spod, from Sydney.
Hi. Hello, Spod.
I'm from Sydney. I'm not good
He's
at this
not,
kind of thing.
They don't have technology
I
in
understand.
Sydney.
Thank
you so much for taking time out of your schedule to come to visit here at the illustrious Channel 31 studios.
I'm very lucky that it's you, Rose.
Yeah.
I feel very honoured.
Oh, thank you. That's such a nice thing to say. Elle McFeast, I mean, I was like live and sweaty. I used to watch that when I was, I think I wasn't allowed to watch that.
Mm.
I'd like kind of sneak out.
It's a very confronting show.
Yeah. Well, how did you get started in comedy? So you are one of these lawyer comedian types.
Yeah.
Why is that? Why do so many lawyers become comedians?
I just have to, I've sort of moved myself around a bit. There you go.
Is that better? That looks good. That looks nice.
Work yourself out. And why do so many lawyers become... Well, that's so that you know how far you can go, I think.
Mm.
And also because when we went through law school, I know this might sound really weird, but you didn't have to pay.
Oh.
So a lot of smart kids got to get educated beyond their...
Class structures, would you say?
Yeah, it was a real meritocracy.
John Howard ruined it, didn't he?
Well, I don't know whether he ruined it, but that was just the way it was.
Yeah.
So, you know, the kids who were the smart asses up the back of the class got to do really good degrees and learn how to think really clearly. And that's why I'm not on my Pat Malone.
Mm.
You know, there are quite a few. And then once you set the path, all the smart asses up the back of the bus thought, who got the good marks, thought, oh, you know, I'll do that too.
So is that why you're so articulate?
No, I've just been talking an awfully long time.
Mm, I talk a lot, I don't know what to say. You're very like well spoken, you know, like you just enunciate very well.
Well, that's because I work on the radio.
Well, that's true.
You
but even back in the day, like, you know, was it one day just like, boom, you're like, what's the cameras
no,
on?
No, I had speech and drama classes when I was.
Speech classes?
My son's at school, yeah. And we had to, yeah. And my best piece in the competitions, me and Kylie Minogue, different categories, all went through. There were a heap of people that used to do speech and drama competitions.
You were in the thing with Kylie Minogue?
Well, I wasn't in with her, but she was in the same program. I think it was like the Maudie Alica Stedford. But she used to do tap dance and song and shit. And I did drama, comedy, and impromptu reading, it was called. And impromptu reading's hilarious because they used to give you a book and you'd get
just
to scan it for a minute and then you'd have to read it and then they'd judge you.
What? That's
so like
weird.
We were like 8, 9, 10, 11.
Huh. Yeah. Just reading a book.
Well, it was they'd give you the Bible or something really complicated.
It's indoctrination, that's what it is.
Kind of.
So you're a bit of a slashy, you know, you've done a bit of everything. Multi-talented. You know, you've done... Well,
I
so
was the first prototype of Waleed.
Oh, really?
Came out as a girl.
Yeah, well...
And the wrong...
How did... So you...
That's probably not very good.
Were you the only woman with like a show, like hosting your own show?
Yeah.
Yeah. How'd you slip that past them? Like, it's pretty...
Sydney.
Yeah.
Arrest my case.
Yeah.
Sydney.
He's trying to say that
so
Sydney's
I was in
better.
Melbourne on Live and Sweaty... Well, what happened was, Rose, is that there was this whole, like, comedy thing that was going on in Melbourne around the radio stations.
Mm.
So, I'm just trying to work out when it was. So,
like a Tony Martin or something back then?
No, it was before Tony Martin. It was Richard Stubbs.
Okay.
So, he was the first comedian who was given their own breakfast show.
Now it's all comedians.
Exactly. You guys have this
Stubbsy
kind of career path. We didn't have career paths, and I didn't even know.
I don't know if I've got a career path.
Well, at least you can see where they've been.
Yeah.
Like the comedians these days, they're young and they go through raw comedy or they do whatever, and they can see, right, breakfast radio show, that's where I'm going. So they'll start on the weekend and then they'll do that and then they'll get their TV series or whatever. Well, I don't even know when all of this happened. But I think it was because I grew up in Melbourne listening to the Coulda-beans and all of their comedy phone calls that they still do. And it was all about football, right?
Yeah.
But as a girl growing up in the 70s and 80s in Melbourne, you couldn't play football. You couldn't be involved in football. But football was the ruling.
I played football.
See?
Well, no. I was a baby feminist and I played football in grade 4 and 5, even though I hated it because there was no other girls on the football team.
You must have loved it.
No, I got bullied a lot, but I was just very stubborn. I got dacked at an inter-school football game once. Ooh. I know.
So what do you think's better, getting dacked or getting a wedgie?
Wedgie. Yeah.
Because nothing gets shown.
Yeah, exactly. It's like you've also been there before.
Well, I couldn't play football. When I looked at all the important people in town, they were all footballers, and the women with them went to the Brownlow.
Yeah.
And there was no way I was going to be one of those girls that went to the Brownlow. And so I made up this comedy character, El McFeast, that fitted in with Richard Stubbs had his brother Grubby on the XY Zoo, and El McFeast went on Grubby's Saturday morning football show with Trevor Marmalade called Kick to Kick.
Oh, yeah.
And they all had fake names, so I made up El McFeast because it was the 90s, I think, and El McPherson was on the front cover of Sports Illustrated, and I'd stop on the way home.
And you did voiceovers for Sports Girl?
Yeah.
And they told you to sound like El McPherson?
Yeah, and I said,
and is that where it came from?
Hungry.
Yeah. I sound really hungry and
because I was in this comedy band called The Hot Bagels at that stage. It was all happening late 80s.
That's
crazy. It sounds like I had a lot of fingers in a lot of pies, I've always had wanted to do things.
You've got to do lots of things. You've interviewed, what was it like meeting Julia Gillard?
I was always impressed with Julia Gillard.
Mm.
Yeah.
She held herself with poise.
Well, she also told women it was all right to wear glasses on television. Oh. Have you noticed they all wear her glasses now? Virginia Trioli?
No. No one's it. Oh, yeah. No, people say it's annoying because it reflects off the... See? It's a real big... It's
so cute to see you here doing this. Wow. I'm so happy.
Oh, thank you. That's so nice.
Mm. Mm. It's good. So when they threw me in, you don't want to go through the whole palaver of ins and outs or whatever, but I was only 24, 25 when I... how old was I when I took over hosting Live and Sweaty? I don't know, but maybe 25 or 26, maybe I was, 28? I don't know. Anyway, I moved to Sydney to do it. But that was because initially they were looking for a sports reporter in Melbourne for this Sydney-based show that they'd made up a comedy show about sport, and they'd made it up for HG and Roy, right?
Yeah.
But HG and Roy decided they didn't want to do it at the last minute.
And that's when you swooped
in. No, Andrew. They gave it to Andrew Denton. And then they needed because he was rugby league, they needed AFL.
And that's where you come in. Mm. The Melbourne girl.
All
right. Well,
that's
football?
That's a long story, isn't it?
No, but it's interesting. It's part of our culture. What football team do you go for?
I barracked for Collingwood.
Barracked?
Yeah. Well, that's like being a lapsed Catholic.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I go for Richmond. So
I barrack for Richmond now too.
Oh, okay. Good. Why did you choose them?
Because I like them.
Well, there's something charming about them.
My uncle barracked for Richmond.
We can't talk about football. Why am I talking about football? I had an hour show to talk about whatever I like, and I've got Libbi Gorr here. I'm talking about football.
Well,
anyway.
It's actually talking about women doing things in male-dominated industries.
Exactly.
That's what you're trying to get
to. That's what I'm doing. I'm on a Tonight Show. They let a woman on a Tonight Show.
And you like to talk about relationships.
Yes, I do.
And dating.
Like, we don't have... They're like... I'm like... So, it all started, I do, but we'll have to save it for another time because we've run out of time.
Never mind.
Thank you so much for coming on.
My pleasure.
People can catch you on 774
yes,
on Sundays.
And they can also catch me on 7:30.
Yeah. And any other, like Twitter or anything like that you want to plug?
I think you just look for Libbi Gorr.
Yeah, well, obviously. All right. Thank you so much, Libbi.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
And we will be right back with more after the break. Hello and welcome back to About Tonight here on Channel 31. I'm really excited to welcome our next guest, Jen Kirkman.
Thank you. I just threw confetti at myself. Thanks for having me.
Well, you're like, I'm gonna celebrate me.
Totally celebrating myself.
It's a real honor to. You've got a big thing stuck in the middle of your hair there. But
that's all right.
That's fine.
I think it's cool.
It kind of looks like toilet paper, but maybe it is. Maybe I just.
Is toilet paper.
That's good.
Thanks, guys.
This is Spod, my musical guest.
Got to hit pause.
Yeah, that's what you really did. You did a great job.
Thanks.
You're fired. No, I'm just kidding. So welcome to Melbourne again.
Thank you.
You've been here a bunch of times now, right?
This is my third year here for the festival.
I heard that you're really into how everyone tells you how great the coffee is in Melbourne.
Oh my god, it's so annoying. I just had an incident this morning in my hotel. There's a coffee shop in it. And look, I'm the type of person that sips on a coffee for hours all day long. Is this bothering you?
It's just really, that's so, okay,
I'm not the kind of person that wants to have it, get it done quick, and then I'd like to sip all day. And so I ordered a long black, and I just, then it's that much coffee, and I was like, can you just add a lot of hot water
You
to
mean
it?
You want one of those big American ones? That's
exactly
not how we do it.
I know, but I was gonna be, I just did 6 hours of press today, and I was going to be holding my coffee, and I just didn't want to. It gets me too jittery, so I like to draw it out. Yeah,
I did that. I did the jittery. I had a real strong coffee. And I didn't eat, so woo!
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So if I'm at a cafe, I do it proper. But I was like, you know what? It's just the coffee shop in a hotel. They can calm down. And so the one guy was like, well, then it wouldn't be a long black anymore. Oh, no. And so then the guy that worked there was like, she did this last year, which I was weirded out that he remembered.
That is weird.
So it must have either made a lasting impact
on
my rudeness.
Why are you still working at the coffee shop?
No! Why am I still a comedian a year later? I should have known better. So I don't mind it, but I love the coffee, but
But people go on about it.
It's too much.
It's our thing, and it's funny because people in Melbourne are Melbourne's known for people are like, wow, Melbourne coffee is so good. But a while ago I Googled the best city for coffee in the world, and it's there's 12 cities that are Istanbul is the best. And I'm like, all of these places, they all think that they're everyone knows that we're
well,
the
that's,
best.
You would think Colombia would have the best
or
coffee. I think Paris.
Italy or
something? That's what I would think. So I'm it's great. I feel it's comes from an insecure place though. And I wanted to say it's good. I love it here. I love, you're not even, don't even reduce yourselves to being about the coffee. It's a great
don't
country.
Don't be the coffee whores.
You're so much more to offer than coffee.
Yeah, our unique laneways that we have.
What culture?
He's from Sydney, and they
love laneway culture.
They don't have laneway culture.
No,
there.
They don't. Do they?
They just have beautiful beaches and really hot.
It's
people.
It's more about yacht culture.
Yeah, yeah, we're talking a lot about.
I'm
yachts
super
before.
Into yachts. I brought my yacht from America here.
This is a difference between where we're at and where.
Yeah,
you're
I have
at.
A yacht. I put on wheels. I roll it down Queen Street. I'll be parking it outside the town hall.
I just want to go in. I was saying before earlier in the show. My career goal is to get a photo on a yacht, and with somebody who has more than 100,000 Instagram followers.
Sure, yeah.
How many Instagram followers do you have?
I don't have 100. I have 100-something thousand Twitter followers.
172,000.
Instagram, I only have 40,000. I don't put enough
only
naked.
Only 40,000.
I don't put enough naked pictures up.
Do you have a sound effect that goes wah wah wah?
Wah, wah,
okay,
wah.
That was pretty good. I feel this isn't a horrible thing to say. I was on a yacht once in Sydney. Was not my yacht. I was the guest of a rich person who was being nice to all the people she knew that were not rich. And we, doodled around the harbor, and it was the greatest. And I took pictures with my friends because it was obvious, we are guests on a yacht. This is pretty. Look, the Opera House. Mm. But I feel when you're a comedian, it gets to the level of being able to get the yacht, then don't take pictures. It's never funny.
They never
What is funny about being wealthy? To me, it's just hide it if you are.
Yeah, I saw a picture of a comedian that was it's you're on a private jet. And I'm like, well, now everyone's like, well, it's an easy way to, comedians like to cut each other down as well. It's like, yeah. What? How did he get that private jet? I want to get on the private jet.
Yeah, I think it's only cool if you're like, if you're the opening act of a comedian who's on a private jet and you take that photo like,
yes.
Oh, I would never normally do this, here is this. But then once it's your private jet, just pretend that
you're
a coach.
Do you have a private jet?
No.
And do you need an opening act?
I don't have either. I don't have either. But I have been on a private jet as someone's opening act. And
really?
I don't like it. It's scary and they're small and I would much rather just fly a regular plane.
Can you say who the act was?
Yeah, it was Chelsea Handler. But she makes it like a funny thing. Like, I fly, it's her thing.
Well, that's sort of her thing being like, oh, I splash money around.
Yeah, she's kind of like,
I'm rich and I'm famous.
She's kind of like a baller. But I hate when people do the faux humility private jet things. Like, oh, what? Was this photo of me in a private jet? Yeah. Like, they don't mention they're in one.
Like and a you're humble like, brag.
Yeah, I hate it. And you're like, I can see that there's like a refrigerator. I know you're on a private
jet. Yeah, it's like a mirror selfie. It's like, oh, do you like my outfit? And there's just like a private jet behind them. Like, oh, here, I totally forgot where I was. Yeah, I just wanted to see if you like my outfit.
Yeah, you either have to like be a baller about it or just pretend, just keep pretending, like Joan Rivers used to do. She used to act like she was always broke. Like, I need to work because I need to make money. It was like, you live in a palace.
Yeah, you're doing totally fine.
Yeah, yeah.
You're Joan Rivers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. I'm Joan Rivers?
No.
Oh, you were saying that. No, I'm just kidding.
No, you can't. Oh my God, she's come back. She's embodied in you. We're going to go to an ad break, and then we will be back with Jen Kirkman here on About Tonight. Welcome back to About Tonight, and we are back with our guest, Jen Kirkman.
Thank you. What a great ad that was. I'm going to buy some.
Oh, yeah. It's probably like a suburban, like, mom and dad, like, white goods store or something.
I'm going to buy one.
You should go and buy that washing machine or something. So thank you so much for coming on. And I was going to introduce you before as my favorite misandrist comedian.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. You do a lot of great work on Twitter.
Thank you. I might just embrace it and become a misandrist.
Yeah.
Or
well, I mean, at some point it's hard not to. You know what I mean? Do you know what a misandrist is?
I have no idea.
It means that you hate men.
Oh, yeah.
It's a term men made up.
Yeah, right.
They made me get you on here as a quota thing.
Yeah, yeah. Fair enough. I get it. But I represent all men.
It's not because of talent, you know, because that's how it works with those quota things. Anyway, you do really good work on Twitter. Just fighting the good fight all the time.
Yeah. I feel like what else am I supposed to do with Twitter if not to expose?
Yeah, exactly.
It just shocks me when young guys sound like old guys. Mm. Like, in a weird way, I almost appreciate the older guy sexism, like slap on the butt, hey, honey. Like, they're oddly, weirdly respectful in a weird way where if you speak up to them, they kind of like that you're brassy. And then if you tell a younger guy, like, hey, you know, you don't need to comment on my looks.
Yeah.
They're like, woo, and they freak out
and
they collapse.
Not a thing. Yeah.
Yeah. They melt like an ice cream on a sidewalk. And it's just so unattractive.
But like the old guy feminism, at least it's like, feminine. The old guy, like, misogyny, at least it's like gentlemanly, I guess.
It's gentlemanly. It's like, gentlemanly.
Open the door for you and I'll pay you less money. But
it's
done with a smile on its face, at least.
Yeah, there's something charming about it.
Whereas young guys are just like, no, women don't get paid less. Or they're like, I'm a feminist, but... Or they get angry when you don't explain it to them in a way that is palatable.
Yes.
To them.
Tone policing. That's my favorite thing to say on Twitter. It's my favorite obnoxious, like, buzzword to say.
Yeah.
Stop tone policing me.
Stop tone policing me. Oh, yeah. Like, oh, because it's like, how dare you get angry when somebody, like, when, like, for you, probably, like, 1,000 dudes a day are like, yeah, I hear what you're saying, but let me just play devil's advocate for a second.
And, like that's so fun. Oh, I love devil's advocate.
I love.
That scared me.
What was that?
I don't know, but it seemed like a puppet was going to come out or something.
Haven't you met our crazy puppet?
I don't think devil's advocate is fun. Or like,
no.
And then they go, oh, sorry, you don't want to hear both sides of it. I go, there's no discussion. You don't discuss both sides of slavery.
Yeah, it's like,
they're just like, one is bad, one is good.
You don't discuss both sides of racism. You know what I mean? It's like if you said, oh, I was with my friend, my Asian friend, and somebody called them a Ching Chong China man, the person wouldn't be like, Look, but you know, there's something to be. They were referring to older Oriental culture or something. You wouldn't do that. You're like, yeah, I know that we're not allowed to like argue about racist stuff anymore because we all know that we're not supposed to be racist unless you are like a proper racist.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's people still hanging on to that, and
you're, like,
God bless
owning
them.
That, which, you know, it's like they're really. There's some balls about that, but then it's like the people that pretend like they're in the middle, but really...
Those are the people that scare me.
The people who act like they're not conservative and like they're like left-leaning.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And then they do stuff that undermine women or like they don't listen to you.
Yeah, they, I think that's the biggest thing.
They get their guy mates to do stuff and create like this bro-y kind of culture.
Right, right, right.
I know that you had a website years ago that was all about promoting women in comedy.
Yeah, I can't believe I did that actually. I'm like shocked at myself.
Yeah.
My friend and I started it in the year 2000, I think. Yeah. It was called girlcomic.net. And we just noticed we were all doing like open mics in New York City, and we noticed that the dudes we know were just writing scripts, and no one had asked them to. They were just writing and being like a normal, confident person, like, I'm gonna try my hand at this, and the women were socialized differently, and they were more auditioning and waiting to get picked for things, and then we were like, just write. The guys say they're writers because they write, so let's just say we're writers and we'll write. And we had women write funny essays, and then we did an interview every month with a different famous woman, and it was really cool. And our tagline was feminism funny, and I can't, like, thinking back then.
It's like before it had come back into the
mainstream.
Yeah,
like back then it was like we thought we're pretty much on the edge of everything getting better, and then it got terrible again.
Yeah, I know. How did that happen? It's like it's more out in the open, but then it's like like revenge porn and like weird online dating, like entitlement and that sort of stuff.
Maybe it's just it's the last gasp of everything before we fully take over.
I feel like it's a revolutions have to be like, people are like, why are you getting so angry? It's like, well, didn't like there's been like stuff in wars and things like that before things have changed. It's like,
yeah,
it's a revolution.
It's fine to be angry. And my new thing is like, I don't understand how women haven't just got taken to the streets.
Yeah,
like,
I know.
With guns or whatever.
Well, that's what
or
I
done
said.
Like a sex thing in that like that Greek thing, Lysistrata, like, do not have sex with any men until they stop and listen and change.
Well, I was saying, like, you know how they're always like, oh, how do we stop violence against women? It's like, well, women, like, don't leave the house. And I was like, because we don't have guns in Australia. I'm like, I've got a solution. Guns, but only for women.
Yes.
That would really stop it, like, really quickly, I think.
I said that once on Twitter, and someone goes, there's a male comedian who, I guess, is doing a joke like that in his act now. And they're like, oh, I just wanted to let you know I already heard this guy say that. And I'm like, oh, that's good that he's getting that material. That's that's for us to say.
Yeah,
you know, like, I'm going to keep saying stuff like that. Like, but now that guys are like...
Is there a joke about that? That's like
I
a
don't
bit
know.
That I was...
Nah, I know it's a bit I was... I feel like we should still keep doing it because it's our thing to talk about. Like, Louis C.K. has a bit about street harassment, and I have the same thing. And they're like, he said that already. I'm like, well, I experienced it. So he can say it all he wants, and I will not stop saying it.
Sometimes it's like, with the dude, it's like, wow, he's amazing, bit about blur. And then it's like, oh, she keeps whinging about blah, blah, blah.
Know? I've had guys tweet me, like, have you seen Aziz Ansari's TV episode about street harassment? I'm like, I don't care.
I'm in that
I love
episode.
Him,
yeah.
And he's a nice person, but, like, I experience it every day. Like, I don't need to watch an episode about it from a guy's point of view.
Wow, even is that what it's really like?
He just
like?
Blew my mind with the thing I didn't know about my entire life experience.
Well, that's
oh, my
awesome.
God, I sound so bitter. That's not what I... Well, who cares what I sound
who
like?
Who gives a shit?
Yes.
I probably could, like...
Why would I knock your desk over? he's waving us in.
Yeah, it's like he's going, you're doing a great job. No, do you talk about... What are you talking about in your show, just quickly?
My tits look weird, speaking of... Can I say? My show is about all the times in my life where I thought I was like super doing things the right way and then not. So it's like short little stories, and one of them is about being totally self-absorbed on the actual 9/11. About I got blackout drunk the night before and told a friend of mine I was in love with him, and I was already in a relationship. And then I was in New York, and it was 9/11, and I was like, I know, but also I'm having a personal problem.
Like,
so it's about me being an idiot.
Can we think about me for a second?
Yeah, I did a talent show when I was a little girl, and there's a whole thing about I ruined the popular girl's number, and I had to go to anger management, and taking a fear of flying course and failing, all kinds of things I've done that are stupid.
Yeah.
That's
and
awesome.
And the show ends with a story about a road rage incident.
No way, but yeah. No, it sounds great.
No, all right, well, yeah.
Sounds amazing. It's on at the Arts Centre until the 6th of April.
That's true.
And it is called I Know What I'm Doing and Other Lies. I've told myself.
I tell myself. Yeah. Whatever it is. Okay. It's long
basics,
enough of a title.
Basic,
you get it.
Just Google Jen Kirkman. Go and troll her on Twitter.
Yes, please do.
Don't do that. Please
no,
don't.
No, don't.
Thank you very much for joining us, Jen Kirkman.
It's been so lovely to be here. Sorry to be a misinterest.
No, yeah. I hate men too, so it's fine. All right, we'll be back after the break. Hello and welcome back to About Tonight. It's the end of the show. Oh, you never found that sound effect, did you? Oh, well, you know what? You know, it's been a really great time. Like, thank you so much for being my house band, Spod.
It's been an honor. Yeah. I think I nailed it, so you're welcome.
I think you killed it, man.
Yeah, thanks. Like, I think you did a really great job.
Thank you.
Should be proud of yourself.
I don't really hate men.
No. Yeah. Oh, I do.
Okay, yeah.
I get it.
Yeah, I kind of do. But not you. Like, you're good.
I'm not really a man.
Yeah.
More of a myth.
Yeah. Yeah. You're a... What's the
is cool anybody? Guy?
Yeah, you're a super cool guy.
Super cool guy.
And yeah, thank you so much. I think you did an amazing job. I want to thank all my amazing guests that I had. Yolanda, the mysterious pop singer, Bart Freebairn, Jen Kirkman, and Libbi Gorr. They were amazing. Did you say that, do you have a show at the Comedy Festival, Rose?
Hey, Rose, do you have a show at the Comedy Festival?
Oh my God, Spot, I totally do. Oh,
tell us about it, please.
Oh, thank you. Well, it's right. Actually called Rose Before Hose.
Right, that's a great name.
I know, that is a very clever name
very
for
clever.
A show. Yeah, and it's on the 5th to the 17th of April at the Forum Theatre.
Great.
Which you probably know, like you're not from Melbourne, but you know it's like a pretty like prestigious.
Yeah, I think I've performed there with Duran Duran. It's not a big deal.
In the big room?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm in a room called the carpet room, which is called the carpet room because they store carpet in it the rest of the year.
Hey,
still good though.
Yeah, got to get the job done.
Hey, I can say I shared a venue with Madonna now, so not many people can say that. So it's pretty exciting. So yes, 5th to the 17th of April. Buy tickets on Ticketmaster. Follow me on Twitter at @Operation_Rosie, R-O-S-I-E. Facebook, Instagram, Spodamonic on Twitter.
True.
Where we met.
Yeah.
All those, like, a few years ago.
Cybermates.
Yeah, cyber
pretty
friends.
Cool stuff.
I also, what's that? Do I have a podcast?
Do you have a podcast?
Yeah, oh my God, I totally do have a podcast.
I never knew.
Wow, it's the Revolution podcast.
Prince.
That's actually where I get all my money from.
Right, yeah.
You know, that podcast cash that everyone talks about all the time. Yeah, it's called Swipe Night. It is about sex and internet dating, and it's rated explicit 18+ on iTunes. So yeah, find it on iTunes, Swipe Night podcast, but you know, it's a bit rude.
That's exciting for the kids who like a bit of rude times.
Yeah, so. If you like rude times, then you'll really enjoy it. And I host that with my friend Kirsten Law. And yeah, so like, look, it's been really awesome. I'm very lucky that you're gonna take us out with a track.
Yeah,
that
a is, hot classic.
It's a hot classic. I requested this myself. It's actually about Sydney.
It is, unfortunately.
Yeah.
Sorry to Melbourne.
So it's okay. It's from this album. Can you close up on that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's hot.
That's a good shot of my arm, too, I think.
I used to have two backing dancers,
Spod,
but they quit because
taste
I never paid them.
The Radness is the album. It's also got a moderate impact language warning on the front. You can get that at Brash's, Sanity.
Yep, J5 or something.
The one of those
definitely.
Rural ones that, you know.
Virgin Megastore.
The Virgin Megastore.
30 copies, so let's go. Let's
or you
do
can
it.
Tape it off your friend's tape.
Yeah, you can it. Tape it off someone's telephone these
yeah.
days too, so.
Yeah.
It's a different game.
Yeah, it's technology's changed a lot.
Yeah. But it's a great album. Like I was saying before, that album is now old enough. If it was a person, it would have pubic hair.
Yeah, it would have pubic hair. If you, depending on when you developed, it'd be 12 years old because it came out. Look, it doesn't matter. All right, to take us away, please welcome Spod for his grand final closing song, 2131, Ride With Me. Thank you very much.
Hey guys. A cold wind blows through. Heartbreak Avenue. And we got the top down and the beats turned up. Boys and girls everywhere trying our luck. Yo, it's times like these, in this summertime breeze, that makes lovers make it and platonic friends take it to the other level, rubbing bodies in the naked. Love and sex fills the air. Flying underwear, rubber milk on the hair without a care. Strippers on chairs in our murky layers. And now it's time for our love to junction. Urge to merge at our business luncheon. And everyone in the room is getting it on. So who's gonna ride with me? This jam's 110 degrees. Cause all the boys want it and all the girls got it. Take this lovin' and you put it in your pocket. So who's gonna ride with me? This jam's 110 degrees. All the boys want it and all the girls got it. Take this lovin' and you put it in your pocket. Yes, thanks. Cognac spilt on the silk sheets to the tune of SPOD beats. Liberate your pants all nice and neat.
We didn't
get
use this
everyone
up.
Everyone making love in the streets.
We need to get rid of this now.
The sunrise to sunset. Hot, hot, hot. Wet, wet,
so
wet. We dance to Liberace in my private jet. And buy diamond suits. We cancel chicks.
Wait,
now we
other.
Rule supreme in pink limousines. Ladies peeling off their Gucci jeans as a 213 and cool coat enter the scene. Now it's time for this party to end. From broken hearts to bodies on land, we all fade away to the start of another day. So who's gonna ride with me? This jam's 110 degrees. All the boys want it and all the girls got it. Take this lovin' and you put it in your pocket. So who's gonna ride with me? This jam's 110 degrees. Cause all the boys want it and all the girls got it. Take this lovin' and you put it in your pocket. Diamonds fill your eyes. I can't remember this bit. Do you remember this bit?
Do you want me to look up the lyrics?
Yeah, this is where I used to have dancing girls and they'll sing this bit. But,
I could have danced, but...
Yeah, I couldn't be bothered learning this bit. Just solo.
I did a twerk shop once. Wait, it's the wrong...
You get it on... Oh, that's intense.
You can't see my butt. That's, like, not the point. Actually, no, I'm...
Man, that was a really great solo. The first twerk solo on television. So thanks for having me. It's been really great fun. It's great being on TV. So who's gonna ride with me? If anyone has any work going, I don't know how to act or anything, but I've got headshots. So just give you guys just anything. Like, you know, I don't know if I could really present, but I can give it a shot. But thanks for this opportunity. I don't know. It's a dream come true being on TV. So thanks a lot. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thanks. Peace. Girls got it. Take this lovin' and you put it in your pocket. So who's gonna ride with me? This jam's 110 degrees, cause all the boys want it and all the girls got it. Take this lovin' and you put it in your pocket.